السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، نشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله الأمين ورحمة للعالمين، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، أيدي ريسبكتد شيوخ إمامز سبيكرز young talented speakers. Specifically, I'm very happy when I come to a conference and most of the speakers are young people. By the way, this last time I had honestly to tell you when Tien was born. He was born in 1950, and I'm 3 years older than him. People don't believe that. My daughter saw him one time and saw that Imam Sarai is 3 years younger than him. She said, really? So, alhamdulillah. Hi. Just to say Jazakumullah khairan, especially for Amir and Mustafa. We have been together in this IONA conference in Canada. This is the first time I come to the States for the last maybe 4 or 5 years. And alhamdulillah, Jazakumullah khairan. And especially for the choice of the subject. I said this yesterday. Now, I'm going to throw points, because if I tell you what I have prepared, it's going to be long. Let me take the points one by one. Among the things that people don't know about me is this. Alhamdulillah, I'm old enough. I've been here for 38 years now. And these 30 years, I came back 29 years ago. I mean, when I was only 29, this is 30 years ago. Alhamdulillah, Allah gave me 8 children. 3 of them are in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now I have 5 children, I have 5 grandchildren. And I have been a principal of a school for 17 years. And I left that school exactly 18 years ago. So the kids who were in kindergarten, actually one of them is a professor of medicine in the University of Toronto. One of them is one of the prominent poets. Actually, he's ranked as one of the upper most society of Canada, you know, as one of the most, top 25 influential boys in Canada. That was a student in kindergarten. I have one of them as a professor of education and all of these people. Now, my royal arm of this school. One of the things I did throughout these 18 years or 17 years I spent in the school is to study the community, the children, the parents. And in my office, I don't remember, so I visited me as a medical out there. I don't really remember it, but behind me there was a big sign that says, the least expected child can come with the most unexpected act. I'm going to repeat it, the least expected. Like some families think they're in the safety zone, everything is fine, their children, but you don't know what they do behind you. Now, these 17 years taught me a lot, and I can sit with any one of you. I can tell you there isn't anything that anyone can talk about that didn't come and pass by me. You know the sister mentioned about the sister Bazi, about the sister Kemha. Actually, a student came to me and she said, Ammu, I want to ask you a question. What if I feel attracted to somebody else? What is wrong in that? Why the Quran say this? Why Mazhar say that? Then it became a big issue. And you know, when the parents jumped on it when they knew about it and so on and so on. Imam Sarai said, you don't know what your children do at night. But I'm going to tell you this. I have cases of kids who slip over the window, go with boys in there, and they come back with them sometimes, but by luck they discover. I know girls who hashtag somebody slipped, made them in the yeah, a bit, anything can happen. Some Muslims actually don't want to talk about this because they say, want to this deny it. But some of them even use a rational Islamic argument. Say to me, Shaykh, you should not talk about this because Allah said, Inna al-Ladina yuhibbuna al-Shi'a al-Fahisha. Because this is spreading. Some of the parents say something more important than this, and they have a very good logic. They say, well, bring people to speak about these things, children will learn them. Like Imam Sarai mentioned things about, They say, when people talk about these kids, actually go and do it. You know, we had a case, and this is very interesting, where we have a boy who gives his parents a very hard time. He steals, he does this, he does that. And then they have a policeman, a Muslim. He said, I'll keep him with me. He kept him in his house, he stole from the police and jumped from his window. And it seems like this to happen. So that group says, don't spread it, don't talk about it. Some people say, when you tell people not to do it, you bring this, like law enforcement agents, people are doing that, to speak to our high school children, and so on and so on. And what they say, people learn all the tricks they are warned about, and they go and do them. You know, this is what happened to Sulaiman and the Shayateen and learning magic. You know, the Quran says, yeah? واتبعوا ما تتلو الشياطين على ملك سليمان، ما كفر سليمان ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر، وما أنزل على الملكين ببابل هاروت وماروت، وما يعلمان من أحد حتى يقول إنما نحن زينا فلا تكفر. What they do, like Allah sent these people to teach these angels about magic, and they told them everything. Then what they did, and they said to them, don't use what we told you, don't do it. فلا تكفر. Then he said, فيتعلمون منهما ما يفرقون. And then they went and actually practiced exactly what they were not going to. So some parents are reserved because of this. But actually, yesterday I had Amir Mustafa, today, you need to face these things, as he said, repeat the word head on. Otherwise, we'll be blinding ourselves. And by the way, when I'm going to talk to a prophetic way, I'm going to bring it back to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, the prophets and the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala went through the same. They were human beings like us. Some of them, their children disbelieved. Some of them, Adam alayhi salam, Abu al-Anbiya, his child, his son, kills his brother, right? And Allah told us in a very good way, he said, فَطَوَّعَتْ لَهُ نَفْسُهُ قَتْلَ أَخِي فَقَتَلْ. Yani, that's it. Nuh alayhi salam, what did his son do? What is his wife? Lot, his wife, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala claimed to be kafir. And like Yusuf alayhi salam, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about him, what did their brother? This is the brother, children of the Prophet. All his life was telling them, ما تعبدون من بعد. قالوا نعبد إلهك. And then they took their brother, they want to murder him and actually throw him to die. They lied, they came crying to their father. Allah described what our children sometimes do, what they do. جاءوا أباهم عشاء يبكون. Like they were killed, we call it cold-eyed tears. These are children of prophets. So Allah is bringing this closer to us so that we don't, I mean, and by the way, this all happened. I have seen all kinds of children. I don't know how I can say it. Am I safe to say something like this? In some countries, if children, what they are doing here, they do it, they will bury them alive. And I have to say this, they will bury them alive. I have seen kids talking to their fathers, and I couldn't believe it. I don't want to talk to this person. Not his father, not my dad. You are not my dad. Wallahi, I hear this, or keep saying that. So all these, but the basis of it, and these prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, told us how they brought their children. Look, for instance, and there is a lot to do. It's the story of Luqman. How did he speak to his son? By the way, before Allah tell the story of Luqman, he told us who Luqman is. Right? وَلْقَدْ أَعْتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ حِكْمَةً. حِكْمَةً أَنْ اشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. Because the peak of wisdom is to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After he introduced him, he said, then وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِبْنِهِ وَهُوَ يَعْذُهُ. First thing, قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ. Because if we build faith, you know, it doesn't matter what you say to your children, this is haram, halal, it goes from here and passes from here. But if you build the faith in their hearts, you build the love of Allah, you don't need to tell them anything. They will do it by themselves. And how these prophets build this faith actually is, they are very clear of their relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How do we relate to Allah? The first and foremost is that we submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in servitude, ubudiyya. Imam Sarai, alhamdulillah, I tell people, I mean, African Americans, my God, brothers, right, they are a little sensitive of the word of abd. I am abd. Slave, servant of Allah. I'm an African, I come from the Sudan, and I tell people the honor Allah gave to the Prophet is called him abd. The best time the Prophet, the closest ever, Rasulullah came to Allah, Allah used the word slave, servant, not khadim. You know, because of this sensitivity, people don't want to use the word slave. They use, oh, the servant of Allah in translation. The word servant is khadim. And khadim is a free person. You can have a contract, you can leave. A'ab cannot leave. And we are abid or imam. By the way, the equivalent word of my name is Abdullah. So I love this name. And the equivalent of it, the feminine, is Amatullah. Right? Now, look at what Allah said about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You read in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to him, to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he revealed the Quran to him, he said, well, Alhamdulillah, الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب. He's, or praise to Allah, who sent upon his slave servant, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah took you for the journey of Isra, what did he say? Subhan alladhi asra bi'abdihi. This is slave servant. And then when he stood up to God, قال أنه لما قال عبد الله. And the Prophet used to say, إنما أنا عبد الله. I am a slave servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we understand this, if we can make it to our children that we are, by the way, I'm saying this, alhamdulillah, have our Christian brothers here. In the Quran, Allah describes Isa alayhi salam by saying this, لَنْ يَسْتَنْكِفَ الْمَسِيحِ أَنْ يَكُونَ عَبْدًا لِلَّهِ. Jesus Christ, Isa alayhi salam, will not refrain from subjecting himself in servitude to his Lord, his Creator, not Almighty. Not even the closest of angels to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said to his son, قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. And yesterday I said in the khutbah, the struggle really between deen and dunya, simple as that. There's this dunya with all of it, the shayateen, the attractions, all the temptation. And then what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the commands for us, although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He created everything for ourselves. Everything for us. So the first thing that if we can build this in the heart, you don't need, once I put this in my, when I have a child, my child goes wrong, I don't like telling him, didn't you know this haram and halal, didn't you know this, and I say to him, where do you stand from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Did you forget Allah? You forget that He sees you, He looks after you. Even what you whisper, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ. You know now I'm speaking, and people are reacting to different. Everything comes to your mind. What is he saying? What is he? All of this Allah knows. Naturally, Allah knows even what you whisper to yourself. So these prophets, all these stories, we are being taught because they are all this, and they built this in their children. قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. The greatest injustice is this. Second, he said to him, يَا بُنَيَّ, oh my son, إِنْ تَقُوا مِثْقَالُ حَبَّةٍ مِنْ خَرْدَلٍ فَتَكُنْ فِي صَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ يَأْتِ بِهَا اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَطِيفٌ خَبِيرٌ. What does this mean? Said to him, oh son, you know if you do a fraction of the size of an atom, or a deed, anything you do, Allah knows it. You cannot escape it, no matter where you hide. Even if it is in a rock, thrown in the heavens, with the plural, or in the earth, Allah will bring it forward because Allah is so gentle. Allah does not punish us by what we do. So this is why if we want to take this in an hour and really deal with these things, we have to make sure that this faith and this iman and the love of Allah in their hearts. Otherwise, we'll be wasting our time. Right? Now, the second thing, that when Nuh went, and then he started correcting him, يَا بُنَيَّ أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ, because it's a relationship, وَأْمُرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَنْهَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, then he started telling him all of these things, step by step. And this is what we do. I can take every prophet for this. Ibrahim عليه السلام, how he disciplined his son. وَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعْهُ السَّعْدِ, when he reached that, start talking to him. Actually, one of the biggest, I remember, wallahi, I love, sometimes I can't forget Imam al-Malik. I remember the election of democracy. One time he said, you should democracy in the house. Democracy is not just the institution. It is in the family, with your wife, with your children. Remember that, I think, in a conference, that's where it's still in my mind. That really, if we do with our children, alhamdulillah, now, even little kids, by the way, these children, I'm telling you this, our children tend at times to be more smart than us. And they sing faster than us. And they watch everywhere they sing. And they grew up, and sometimes, as you say, just like the frog, we don't realize. I mean, now I have a father, by the way, mashallah, one of the fathers. His first son is this prominent boy. His second son actually is at Harvard Law School. His other son is one prominent physician. Wallahi, one of our students, a professor of medicine. He's in kindergarten. His other son, I still told me, I used to call my children and sit now at. They are guided my way, they do this, they do that. But these kids now are more smarter than fathers. Right? And they do things that do. And sometimes we forget that. We think we can just suppress them. Don't do that. Do this. Hurry. And then you get angry. And then it doesn't help. It doesn't help. The parents should communicate properly with their parents. You know, I put some ingredients for some parents. I said, number one, you have to have trust in your children. You have to trust them. You have to have confidence in yourself. You have to open communication with them. You have to be very considerate what they are. You have to be tolerant. You have to remember who we are. Did we make mistakes? Everyone of us made mistakes. And some of us, by the way, when they admitted, we were worse than our children when we were young. Just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us out of it. When you tell your children this, they will feel more relaxed. They want to give and take. They will tell you all their problems. They can't be issues. At times I tell parents, how much time did you give a child to sit down and not to ask them, did you do your homework? Are you going to listen? Just ask them how they feel about life. What is it that is bothering them? What is it that's our friends? What do you think of this? What do you think of that? You know, these children will open up to you in a way that you will not believe how you done. And then they will admit to you their weaknesses. Wallahi, a son came to his father out of the blue. He said, Dad, I didn't have to tell you this. You think of me this way, you think of me this, I hear you that, but you don't know. I am involved in drugs. And he told him when it started, how it started. The father Quran completely collapsed, started crying. But what he do? His son came to him, fact. And he is the one who kept, didn't go and trap him, didn't find him like this, didn't sneak in his room. I have seen parents going every day like crazy. Well, why Allah told me this? Every time I have children come, she runs, they go to the washroom, she goes in their rooms, takes him down. They want to go there. You're not run nuts. I'm telling you, you're run nuts. And they do this, and the kids now, one day, this child told me, I came to my room and I found my wife in the closet looking, and I was saying, Mom, what are you doing? No, no, nothing, nothing, nothing. And the boy said, Mom, what are you looking for? And then he was shocked because the boy was innocent. But the mother said, she said, oh, your friend and this friend and that friend and this friend and so on. Parents, I'm telling you this, that trust should be given. And give that room for them, that space. Let them think of it themselves. Even don't get shocked. And sometimes we panic. Yeah, when you reach about Alhamdulillah, and pray for your kids. Pray for your kids. And I have five children. Alhamdulillah, all of them finish university. I sailed through. If Allah make it easier for you, and I don't know their secrets, I'm telling you. But if you sail through, at least on the service, say Alhamdulillah. I'm telling you, say Alhamdulillah, because they are vulnerable. There isn't any night, Allah is my witness, even last night, that I don't sleep without reading Surah Al-Sajdah. I can't believe this. And every night I promise you, actually my grandchildren now find me and see you, they come and pray on my back and they say, Jiddu means grandpa, give up. And I keep praying for my children one by one, my grandchildren one by one, ask Allah, beg Him to protect me from actually my own sins. You know why? Because sometimes we commit a sin and Allah punishes our children. One of my best dua is to say, Ya Allah, do not punish my children with my own sins, my own shortcomings. Because we do sin sometimes, we don't realize they have a direct impact on the children. Direct impact. We make mistakes too. And we do a lot of things that we have to do, and that's why. And these prophets, all of them are singing, and I don't want to go on the listing, but each one of them, Nuh alayhi salam. Longest prophet ever lived. What did Allah say about him? About his wife?
He betrayed him.
ضرب الله مثلا الذين كفروا امرأة نوح وامرأة لوط كانتا تحت عبدين من عبادنا الصالحين. If Allah says these two prophets, Lot and Nuh, were among the best, the most عبدين, that's why they call them عبد, يعني they are among the best of our slave servants. So they had wives, they betrayed them. You know what the wife of Lot did, you know what the wife of Lot did, and so on. And so it is not what you do. And this is why I just want to say this for parents. If your child goes wrong, don't feel about it because of you. No, not necessarily. And some people say, oh, look at Imam Abdul, let me talk about it. Look at the son. Alhamdulillah, Allah didn't. I hope and pray Allah doesn't put me in that position. But sometimes if an Imam's son goes wrong, and we have so many Imams, their children were so wrong. And then people say, oh, look at this Imam, why did he come and talk to people in conference and giving them money? Why fix his family? Thinking that because his son did something wrong, now he has to be wrong. There's something wrong. This is a totally, totally wrong idea. You can be a prophet like Adam, your son could kill his brother. You can be a prophet like Nuh, and your son can make mockery of you. You can be a prophet like Yaqub alayhi salam, and your sons will persuade to take your children out of jealousy because they want, they were jealous about They were jealous before about Yusuf alayhi salam and then Binyamin. And you know the story. You know children can do things Look at the description Allah gave to the children of Yaqub. And look at this position. Just imagine this again. Yusuf alayhi salam, they throw him in the well to die, they forgot about him, he saw to die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah gave him the wahi that will tell you what they do. So then Allah saved him. Then he goes to Egypt, he becomes that prominent man. His own brothers come, they didn't know him. Alas, they didn't know him. So he changed, they didn't know that this is their own brother that they thought he died a long time ago. Now he demanded from them, the story is long, I'm not going to recap it. And then they said to him, if you don't bring your brother, I'm not going to save you next time. They go to their father, tell him another story, and the story was, and then finally the father, they said, that will melt him. But now you give me a fair commitment before you did Yusuf, then I'll take him with you. I mean, they take his brother. The brother goes there, Yusuf takes him aside, tell him that he's his brother, and that's going to keep him in a way. Then the story goes like he put the measure of the king and so on. Finally, he helped him. Now, in the eyes of them was because he stole the measure. And look at what these brothers said of their son to their own brother. They said to him, Yasrik, if he stole, فَغَسَّرْغَ أَخُلْ لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ. You know how painful this is? They say to him, to Yusuf, if he stole his brother, who is he himself standing, he was also a thief. And they tried to, this brother saying about their brother. You know how painful is that? Imagine yourself, people want to kill you, and you don't know. And their brother, they say, if your brother stole, his brother who is you, is stolen. Can you imagine how painful that would be? These are children of prophets. They did it. Nobody said, everybody is vulnerable. All what we need to do is to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah saves and protects and secures our children. Yesterday I mentioned that the dua. Prayer. That can save Allah. One of the things that I know people from Pakistan, they have this beautiful thing. You get a booklet called Rabbana, you see? So they can see all the dua in the Quran, say Rabbana, 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 right? I love it, to be honest with you. Because they memorize everything. Allah teaches us to pray for him. Rabbana. Among this Rabbana is all, Rabbana hablana min azwajina wa dhurriyatina qurrata a'yun. Waj'alna, not everyone, lil-muttaqin imam. Lil-muttaqin. Because your son can be a leader of this and a leader of that. If there is no taqwa in it, doesn't. Well, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it doesn't need much. Yes, he can be a prominent name, a prominent figure, a known person, but that doesn't count. Allah says, وَجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. That's what we pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it, and so on. There is a lot to say, and if you ever give me 10 minutes, and I'm sharp on my time, inshallah. I do pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless this conference. I hope when we go to the workshops and so on, we deal with all these issues, and we have tons of things that we can say, inshallah. And we pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect each and every Muslim child, every Muslim father, every Muslim grandfather. By the way, the last note I want to say to you, we as parents, our role and responsibility does not end up in our children, but in our grandchildren. You know why? Yes. MashaAllah, alhamdulillah, you know my daughter Huda, she has 3 now, my son has 2, my other killer. I say because Allah will ask me, did I prepare my son to be a good Muslim father? Did I prepare my daughter to be a good Muslim daughter? So we not only look after them, but we prepare them for the second generation and leave the rest for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help them, inshaAllah. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa ta'ala.